Welcome everybody, this is Youth News. Today is February 20th, 2016. I will be your host today, T. Noss, along with Caleb Steindel. Caleb, how are you today?
I'm doing well, thanks Tyler.
Yep. Alright, so, as I said in our little, the little notice or whatever, I said, well, be mostly talking about other crap because we don't really have anything planned out for today.
Yeah, I got a little bit of sports news surrounding the NFL, but yeah, it's going to be a low-key today.
I have a little bit of music stuff. If you have any questions, just put them in the chat below. Put them on our Facebook page, our Twitter page, and I think that's about it. Oh, an email. We have two emails. Caleb, I'll let you say the one, and then I'll say the other one.
Yeah, so our email address for our, I think we've this one connected to Spreaker, I believe, as well, is pterodactyl369912 at gmail.com. pterodactyl369912 at gmail.com.
And then I will have mine open too at tycover14@gmail.com. So, if you have any questions, just put them in those spots, and then, Caleb, I'll let you talk about your show real quick.
Yeah, so, I've got a show, it's NFL Talk with Caleb Steindel. You can find the show on Twitter, at NFL with Caleb. You can join the Google Plus community, and like the page on Facebook. And the website, you can find out all about the show. The website is www.nfltalkwithcaleb.weebly.com. And basically what we talk about is, well, that's why it's called NFL Talk. We talk about all sorts of NFL news through the regular season and into the off season. And, you know, some people think, well, people aren't as busy during the off season surrounding the NFL. And, well, we talk sports, NFL, all throughout the off season. So I'm actually going to be probably doing a show in podcast form tomorrow night. So keep an eye out for that.
All right. And then I guess for my show, I won't be doing it as often anymore. It'll just be mostly it'll probably be more of if I have free time and then just during the summer. So let's put that's probably gonna be become my show then. It's just free time and stuff. So not really planning. It's just all about music stuff. And yeah, that's about it for it right now. So as there's awkward silence.
All right, thanks, Tyler. So you want me to kick things off talking about some NFL news?
Sure.
All right, sounds good. So the first piece of news I want to talk about is retirements in the NFL this year. Obviously, in case you haven't heard, Steelers tight end Heath Miller recently retired.
Heard about that last night.
The news. Yeah, after 11 seasons, all with the Pittsburgh Steelers, and I really appreciate it when a guy retires, staying on the same team he's been with his entire career. That's what happened with Heath Miller. He's been there for 11 seasons. The team announced news Friday afternoon. He's 33 years old from ESPN. Miller validated his status as a 2005 first-round pick with 592 receptions, 6,569 yards, and 45 receiving touchdowns, all franchise high for the tight end position. He's one of four Steelers to catch at least 500 passes. His career catches and yardage totals rank in the top four among tight ends in the period since he was drafted, according to ESPN stats and info. So when you look at this retirement, because when you take a step back and look at it, we have lost a lot of great players this year. We lost Peyton Manning, most likely, Calvin Johnson, and Heath Miller are three players that have really, really epitomized their status as one of the best in the business and for their respective positions. And obviously, with Peyton Manning, he's all but done. I mean, he hasn't announced it yet, but I think he knows his answer. And I think it's going to be that he's going to retire this year. I don't see how he can keep playing. That's a topic for another show. But with Heath Miller, you got to wonder if any of the any health attributes to his decision to retire. Tyler, I'll let you give your opinion on this, but I can't help but wonder if Heath Miller, and he's 33 years old, so, you know, that is starting to get old in terms of football standards, but got to wonder if there's any health issues that has to do with this, because we've seen players retire at a young age recently because of health issues or because of the potential for health problems, especially in terms of concussions and stuff. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I'm going to agree with you, because that sounds about what's been going on. Sounds like what might... well, that's early. I can't think right now.
I think that probably plays into it a little bit. I mean, I'm sure the majority of it. I mean, he is 33, so not like he's really young. But still, I wasn't expecting to retire this year. That wasn't my expectation. So it's just something to keep an eye on. I think the main reason is probably because of is probably not health related issues. But I just think it's a possibility that played into a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
He's a really classy guy. I've enjoyed watching him play. He's a guy that no matter what team you cheer for, you got to have respect for him, because yeah, I mean, you watch some of the great catches he's made, touchdowns he's made. He is not an extreme celebrator. He doesn't go crazy, you know, once he makes a great play. And there's a little celebration after a touchdown, but you know, they recently Steelers tweeted out a video of one of his best catches. And what did he do after he made the long catch? Flip the ball to the receiver, or flip the ball to the referee, and headed back to the huddle. So I like watching the guy play. It's fun to watch him play.
Yeah. So then I guess I'll talk about some music news real quick. Killswitch Engage has a new album coming out on March 11th. I can't remember the title of it, of the album. I think it's called Incarnation. I pre-ordered it, so I'm waiting for it to come in. So I still have a little ways to wait for it. Also, NF announced Thursday, I believe, he has a new album coming out called Therapy Session. It will be It's available for pre-order now on either your choice of physical or digital. And then there's also, and that comes out April 22nd. And then TFK tomorrow, I retweeted this. Tomorrow, if you listen to SiriusXM, listen in, because TFK has a new single coming out that'll be only on SiriusXM till they release on YouTube and iTunes. And I just pre-ordered I just bought the new TFK single, which is, I think that one's called Incomplete, that's what it is. I just bought that. That was really good. And let me think. Skillet has a new album coming out this year sometime. Whitechapel does as well. Papa Roach is in the studio. Or in the album. Studio, I guess. Recording stuff. And I'm trying to think. Oh, Lecrae has a new album coming out. Forgot about his. And I think that's about it for now for music stuff.
And Tyler, I just checked up on new Killswitch Engage album. It's Incarnate.
Incarnate.
So, yep. That's
oh, and
March 11th?
Yeah, March 11th. Yeah, thanks for looking at that, but I can't remember. A new start with an I.
Yep, Incarnate is the new album.
Yeah.
Okay, I will mention then another bit of news that just came out from this time the St. Louis Rams. Not only have the Rams moved to Los Angeles, but they have...
They're not St. Louis anymore, so get it right.
Yes, they've moved on to Los Angeles from St. Louis.
Weren't they originally from L.A.?
They are moving on. Sorry, what did you say, Tyler?
Weren't they originally from L.A.?
They were originally. They started out in L.A., moved on to St. Louis, and now they are back to Los Angeles. So not only are the Rams moving to Los Angeles, but they're moving on from three veteran players in the process. Per ESPN, the team announced the release of defensive end Chris Long, middle linebacker James Laurinaitis, and tight end Jared Cook on Friday. In releasing the trio, the Rams will reportedly save $24 million in cap space. That could set them up to re-sign some of their own key free agents like cornerback Janoris Jenkins and Tremaine Johnson, and safeties such as Rodney McLeod and Mark Barron. At first, I will admit, this news took me by surprise. I was shocked that they were to cut these guys. But as I looked a little more closely at this, I looked at each player individually, I understood the reason for it. Jared Cook, I mean, I'd say is probably, if you want to go by least talents, Jared Cook probably is the worst player of the three. I mean, he's still been a solid veteran for them over the years. But he's probably the guy that they were least concerned about having to keep him around. So I guess I can understand that. Chris Long was a sack monster in his first few years. In 2012, he had 11.5 sacks. 2013, he had 8.5 sacks. But you look at the past 2 years, 2014, one sack. 2015, three sacks. Okay? The guy has dropped off significantly. And right now is in a time period where they can reminisce in past times. And, oh, you were once a great sacker for our team. You got to look at what's been happening over the past couple of years, and he hasn't been performing. So looking at that, I understand that as well. James Laurinaitis was a guy that I was most shocked about. But look, I understand why they released all three of them. They need a quarterback. And hopefully not only will this new Catalina cap space, hopefully they not only use that to sign a quarterback, which I talked earlier should be Robert Griffin III, but I think they also want to continue to build upon their young defense. I think they want to keep their defense young. And Laurinaitis and Chris Long are two veterans, two guys that have been here for a while. They want to build around Robert Quinn and Aaron Donald, build around the young guys, because I think the defense is a Super Bowl caliber defense. They have a Super Bowl caliber running game. What they need is a quarterback, and if they want to be able to get a Super Bowl caliber quarterback, they're going to need to free up some cap space. I do believe that, though, that they need to cut ties with Jeff Fisher. If not now, next year. Because they're going to need a quarterback, but I don't think just a quarterback is going to be able to get them where they want to go. They've been hovering on the edge of 7-9, 8-8, but I think they need a coach who can actually coach a team to the playoffs. Jeff Fisher has been completely mediocre in his entire regime with the St. Louis Rams. I think they're going to also need a new coach.
All right. So then, Caleb, if I can ask you a question real quick. Do you know